Hey you and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I'm going to be talking about the Acer Chromebook Spin 15. And actually, this is a really nice Chromebook. In this quick introduction, what I'm going to do is basically show you that it does have a backlit keyboard, speakers that are facing up so they're not muffled if you're watching a movie or something there in the comfort of your sofa or bed. And this is a spin model, so that means that it will spin. So let's do that right now. That's right, it does a 360 spin, and you can use it as a giant tablet. And has an excellent touchscreen, as you can see here. And it's very, very bright. And when you're done using it as a tablet, you can spin it around this way. And guess what? You can then use it as a laptop. And I think one of the things I like most about this is it has a backlit keyboard and the speakers are facing up. Besides the fact that it has a very good touchscreen too. That's a 15.6 inch screen. All right, so we're going to be going over a quick unboxing, going over the features, specifications, and some of the other things such as battery life and that type of thing, and whether I recommend this model or not. So let's take a look at this model, you and I. Come on. I found this Chromebook at Acer Recertified for around $260. They have quick shipping and the packaging is rather straightforward with just the Chromebook, a charging cable, which can charge the Chromebook through the USB-C ports, and small paper talking about the manufacturer's 90-day warranty. On the right-hand side of the Chromebook, we find the volume control, USB-A port, USB-C port, and the Kensington security lock. Even though this is a manufacturer's recertified product, I don't see any dents, scratches, or fingerprints on this unit. On the left-hand side, we find the power button, USB-C port, USB-A port, a micro SD card slot, and an audio jack. Setup is a breeze. All I gotta do is open up the lid, and you'll turn on in a second or so, click on Get Started, and then connect to your network. You'll need to know your network's password at this point. Click on Connect, and then click on Accept and Continue. A moment or two, it'll ask you who's using the Chromebook, either you or a child. Select the right one, and then click on Next. Now you need to sign in to your Google account. That's done by keying in your email address, and then clicking Next. And then you'll key in your password, and select Next. Now after a few moments, you'll be at your desktop, and you'll notice that all of your applications will be downloading, including the settings such as your backgrounds and other things that you have set up on your previous accounts will all be now synchronizing with this new Chromebook. Hey, did you know Chromebooks come with perks? Yes, and I have a link to this down in the description. We just click it and you'll open up this page here. So some of the perks that you see, such as YouTube Premium, this is a limited time, so maybe you might get 1 to 3 months on most of these perks. Some of them you get actually for a year. And you can see from this list, that is a very long list. To get any of these perks, all you have to do is click on the little gray button there that says Get Perk, and then open up to a new page, and then make sure that you do qualify for that particular perk. And if you want it, you click on Yes, Get Perk, and then you'll have it in your Google account. And some of these are really good, such as the 100 gigs of extra cloud storage. That's always really convenient. So here's the Acer Chromebook Spin 15, also known as the CB315 specifications. And the very first thing there, I think, is one of the most important specifications. That is the CPU, or the processing unit that's using there. And the central processing unit, that the one that I found, is the Intel Pentium N4200, and it ranks 150 in the top CPUs. Now other models that you can actually find at different locations there. It might come with a Celeron N3450 or the N3350, and those are a little bit slower processors, as you can see there by their rankings. Next is the graphics processing unit, and mine came with the Intel HD Graphics 505, and that is the Apollo Lake. And you can see the ranking there for GPUs is number 329. Now, I did play games already on this one. It does play Android games, and I've been playing Beach Buggy 2 as well as other fun games. No hesitation at all in the gameplay. I've also been creating videos already. In fact, I'm creating this video with this Chromebook, and it's doing a great job in displaying and doing all of the things I want a Chromebook to do. So even though it looks like, oh, it's ranking down there at 329 there as far as top GPUs, it should be more than enough for all of your daily chores that you can throw at a Chromebook. Next is the internal storage. That might be considered like the HDD or the SSD. HDD would be hard disk drive. Chromebooks do not actually have a hard disk drive. They have a solid state drive, actually soldered right onto the main board, and it's actually very quick. This one here came with 32 gigs. Others can actually have up to 64 gigs, as you can see there in that list. That would be awesome to have that. Basically, it means you can store more things on or download more things onto the internal storage. Now, it is possible to upgrade your storage. Simply buy a micro SD card like a 256 or a 512 gigabyte or larger and plug that into the micro SD card reader that's found right on the Chromebook, and you can actually download items or files right straight to the SD card. Next, you have random access memory. Now, you are able to find versions of this that have up to 8 gigs of RAM. Mine that I actually bought for that $260 at Acer Recertified, that comes with 4 gigs of RAM. And you may think, well, is that enough RAM? And the reality is, yes, it is. For all the work that I do, I play games on my Chromebook, really good intensive games. I create all the videos that you've been watching on YouTube. I create those on a Chromebook with only 4 gigs of RAM. And so even though it may sound like a very small number with a Chromebook, with that operating system, it actually is able to utilize that smaller amount of RAM, and you don't get any hesitation or really any lagginess at all. So 4 gigs is A-OK by me. And as you can see in the video, I'm able to create all the effects with 4 gigs of RAM on a Chromebook. And the next specification that we have there is dimensions. Now, of course, this Chromebook comes with a 15.6-inch touchscreen, and that makes this one so large. It also has forward-facing or upward-facing speakers, and that makes it a little bit larger too. So there's the dimensions listed there. And then the next thing that we have there is the weight at 4.9 pounds. And if you like kilograms, it shows the kilograms there at being 2.2 kilograms. Is that heavy? Well, yes, it is. So if you're carrying it around all day long in school, you would notice it there at, you know, almost 5 pounds of weight. For me, I use it around my house, carrying it from the kitchen to the living room, to the office, to the studio and back. I haven't had any problems at all carrying the 5-pound Chromebook. And I also wanted to add something here that I don't see. On that 15.6-inch touchscreen, it does have Gorilla Glass, and basically that means it's a little bit stronger than your typical Chromebook. So it should be a little bit better if you by accident drop it or something like that. It does have a stronger seal on it, and that's called Gorilla Glass. Another specification that I don't see off the bat on this list is the battery life. The battery life that I've actually been testing with this one is very close to 8 hours when I've been using it for basically like watching YouTube videos, doing things on the internet, social media, that type of thing. When I go in and I just do straight gaming with it, like Beach Buggy Racing 2, the battery life goes down to about 6.5 to 7 hours. And still, that's really phenomenal of just basically playing games on the Chromebook and having it do everything for that long a period of time. And so the batteries are very, very good in these. Someone asked me in another video, well, how long does it take to recharge it? Well, on this one here, I noticed that it's less than 30 minutes. So when I plugged it in, 30 minutes, and had the unit off, came back, turned it on, in 30 minutes, it was already recharged for me. Next, you see the ports. Now, I already talked about the ports earlier in the video, but they're listed here so that you get an idea about which ports that comes with, such as the USB Type-C, USB Type-A ports, the card reader, which I think is very important on any Chromebook. You notice that the Wi-Fi is the 802.11ac. That's a faster type of Wi-Fi connection, so that's awesome to have. You also have the Bluetooth 4.2 and of course the 3.5 millimeter audio jack. This one does not come with a fingerprint reader. Now, I haven't needed to use it with mine. I just key in my password. You can actually go into the settings, type in PIN as in P-I-N, and assign a PIN with your Chromebook. So every time you turn it on, you just key in the PIN number so that you don't have to key in that long password every time you get into your Chromebook. And the next thing that we see there is the web camera. So is it a good web camera there? It has a green mark on it. The answer is yes, it is a good web camera. I did test it with Google Meet and Zoom and it performed very well. Now you have to remember that when you're using the web camera, you are using your bandwidth on your internet. So if you have a slow internet, it will reduce the quality of your web camera. If you have a very good fast bandwidth that you pay for, then you have a very good web camera experience. And the next thing that we see there is the backlit keyboard. This one does come with a backlit keyboard. It does say optional there because I was able to find the same model that didn't have it for a little bit cheaper. So when you're looking at the description and specifications before you click on buy, if that's really important for you, make sure it does say backlit keyboard there in the specifications on the advertisement. It does come with a good microphone. In fact, some of the recordings that were recorded today were actually done on the microphone. And the next thing that we have there is speakers. Now, it comes with very good speakers, and these speakers are upward facing speakers, so the sound is not muffled. If you want to watch a movie or a program and you want to watch it while it's sitting on your lap or while you're laying in bed, there's no muffledness at all to the speakers because they're basically always projecting the sound upward and towards you. So I would say these are exceptional speakers, and they get my thumbs up on that. Next is optical drive. That would be like a CD or a DVD or a Blu-ray drive. It does not come with that. I do have videos on my channel that actually talk about how to plug a DVD drive or one of these other optical drives right to your Chromebook and be able to watch movies with the VLC app. So if you're interested in doing that, check out my other videos there on how to connect an optical drive to your Chromebook. And it does come with a security lock slot. That is important, especially for me since I'm a teacher. I will go out and use it on my desk, and then I have to go someplace, right? Well, you don't want to have it walk away by the time you get back to your classroom. So I do use the security lock, and it's there, and I'm glad that it has it. And the last question that we have there is, do I recommend this Chromebook? And the answer is, yes, I do. Well, why do I recommend it? Well, I recommend it, one is, for the awesome speakers. Next is the touchscreen, and the touchscreen has a really high contrast value. The other thing that I really like about this is the backlit keyboard. Having that backlit keyboard is awesome. Sometimes I'm working in my office and I have the lights turned down kind of low. It's maybe late at night. And basically being able to look down at that keyboard and having it backlit, that is a big plus. And the last big plus for this recommendation is the long battery life. If you're just going to be doing normal things with your Chromebook, such as going in, watching movies, going on the internet, doing social media, it should last anywhere between 7.5 or more hours. And if you're playing games and doing really intensive video editing like I do, I was getting more than 6.5 to 7 hours of time there in the Chromebook. So very good battery life. And again, the model number is going to be written right here for you, so that if you were looking for it, you can actually do an Amazon search for that exact model. And I had found it at Acer Recertified, and I'll have a link to where I found it there in the description. All right, hey, if you're new here, please subscribe to my channel. Comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up. And thank you very much for watching the video, and you have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.